Hello again to our global audience. This is a post-interview commentary, post-press TV interview commentary that I just did with the wonderful press TV of Iran. We had a wonderful news today, and you know, this is something to be celebrated in a world where you know, every other news seems to be so negative and energy draining. We had the wonderful news today from Iran and Italy that there's going to be a signing of an $18.5 billion contract between the Islamic Republic of Iran and the Italian Republic. So $18.5 billion would be around 17 billion euros. This contract covers very diversified business sectors such as agriculture, transportation, health industry, and the energy sector. This was just signed between President Rouhani of Iran and President Mattarella of Italy. Italy is being the basically a first leg trip of President Rouhani's three-nation high-ranking trip. He's currently in Rome. This is where this contract was signed. And after this, he will be going to France and Germany, if I'm correct. This high delegation of Iranian businessmen, entrepreneurs, and government officials are finally producing very good results for Iran. The big congratulations should go to the Rouhani administration, and especially Dr. Zarif, who has been working tirelessly during the past 2 to 3 years. And we had the final signing of the agreement between P5 plus one, the JCPOA agreement, and so this finally they're reaping the benefits, and we are some fruits the tree is bearing some fruits finally after 10 years of intense and unfair economic sanctions toward Iran. Going back and elaborating a little bit about this $18.5 billion contract. We heard from Reuters today that 4 to 5 billion of this $18.5 billion contract goes to the Italian oil services group SAPEM, and around $6 billion of the contract goes to Danieli Corporation, which is an Italian steel firm. So we have, and then another 4.5 billion comes from Condotte d'Acqua Corporation, which is an Italian infrastructure firm. So we have heavy industry contracts, usually heavy industry contracts such as the ones that I just outlined for you above are long-term. It's a win-win situation. This is something that the Rouhani administration has been talking about. It doesn't have to be about win-lose. It doesn't have to be about one side winning, one side imposing its will on the other. It is all about win-win between nations, between governments, between peoples, between systems. After this, there will be a trip to France, if I'm correct. And France, of course, the French, the France-based company Airbus is also going to sell 114 passenger jets to Iran in order to upgrade Iran Air's aging fleet. Some of these jets are going to be Airbus 320, Airbus 340, and hopefully Airbus 350 and the double-decker superjet Airbus 380. This will be an incredible win-win situation. I mean, just through the deal with Airbus, this would reinvigorate the Iranian air industry. It will encourage more tourism to Iran. It will generate more revenue for Iran. On the other hand, tourists who do come to Iran, 10 out of 10 have usually have such positive experiences. So going back to their European, Asian, or North American countries, this will be wonderful for the relations between Iran and the West. Iran has never had any problems in its relations with the East. It's just that some of the Western countries, United States, actually, that would be the only country, a little bit Canada, you could say, have been having some problems with Iran during the past 10 years especially, but it really goes back to 37 years ago when there was an Iranian revolution. And so hopefully the moderates and the voices of sanity are taking over in not just Iran, but also we are hoping for that here in the United States. Another development that we've been seeing in the region, which is another example of a win-win, is the Iran and Egypt are resuming trade ties, which I think is also absolutely wonderful. Historically, we have seen very organized efforts by some here in the West to make sure Iran and Egypt, who are the two most powerful nations in the West Asia, Middle East region, along with Turkey, of course, there's been a lot of concerted efforts by some in the West, particularly London, to make sure Iran and Egypt don't become close economically, socially, politically, militarily, culturally, etc. So I think this is another wonderful development between Iran and Egypt, and hopefully we will be witness to a series of closer ties between Iran and some of these countries that have not had the best relations with Iran. I hope you enjoyed this commentary. I will post the video of the interview that was just conducted on Press TV right above this video on my YouTube channel, which is called Truth, Justice, and Peace. I hope you have a wonderful day, and let's keep our fingers crossed for better days to come for humanity and for the nations of the world and for the peoples of the world. Thank you for watching this video, and we look forward to our next interview.